October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and tonight we're meeting a Green Bay area survivor who's helping others during the battle for their lives. CZ Engebretson has the story in our NBC 26 Cares.
Annie Karjala-Dobbins is 4 years cancer-free, but instead of leaving her difficult experience in the past, she's using her journey to give back to other women fighting breast cancer.
Back in 2012, Annie Karjala-Dobbins experienced a series of strange dreams.
I woke up in the middle of the night with this terrible nightmare that I had breast cancer. I did a breast self-exam and there was a lump.
Annie struggled to tell her children and husband she had the fast-growing triple-positive type of breast cancer.
We generally are cast in the role of caretakers and nurturers, and something like this diagnosis very suddenly changes us from being the ones who gives to others to the one who needs to be given to.
Annie had a lumpectomy. Chemotherapy and radiation also left her sick and losing her hair.
I can remember her asking, well, you know, what support do you have here at Aurora Baycare? And I had to timidly respond, well, we do our best to provide support and we have a social worker.
Everyone there took such good care of me, but the only thing I was missing was the ability to really connect to other people going through what I was going through.
So together with her doctor, William Owens, they created a small support group. With Annie's master's degree in counseling and her personal experience with breast cancer, she was the perfect leader for it.
One of the things that we offer in the support group setting that women can't get other places is, it's okay if it's not okay. You can sit in that room and you can complain about your spouse, your kids, your caregivers, whatever it might be.
It's a safe place for women to be honest about their feelings. Ginger Goble has incurable metastatic breast cancer.
Initially, I was like, oh, I don't know if I want to go. I don't want to talk. And it's like, now you can't shut me up. It's just like, what? It just comes out and it's great to be able to do that.
Patients can share what they've been through and what their fears are, and others can provide possibly advice or at least a sensitive and sympathetic ear to what they're going through.
But something that so many of us are unprepared for are the side effects that we feel as we go along the way.
They also share tips.
When I was really nauseated, I, you know, drank ginger ale or, you know, whatever it might be.
Goble encourages both patients and survivors to join them.
Come, you don't have to talk. You can just sit there and be that fly on the wall, and you don't have to talk. It's just nice to listen to, oh, other people are going through this. It's not just me.
Annie says she attacks every session with one goal in mind.
That we can really draw strength and courage and hope from each other.
The Breast Cancer Support Group meets every other week. We have more on Aurora Baycare Medical Center's patient and family resources on NBC26.com. Stacey Engebretson, NBC 26.
Going back to the beginning of the story, can you believe that Annie had a nightmare about having cancer? She was right. Be sure to trust your body. Dr. Owen stressing the importance of early detection. He suggests starting mammograms by age 45 unless there might be a higher risk for breast cancer. Also look for changes. If there's a lump or changes on the skin, do see a doctor right away.